TYT Sports, Rick Strom in studio talking boxing with editor-in-chief of Boxing.com, Robert Exel. Robert, how are you today?
I'm good. How are you, Rick?
I'm doing great. I'm very excited for Saturday. Not just saying that, I am truly excited for Saturday. I felt like we've needed some of these big fights for a while, so let's get down to it. James Kirkland, Alfredo Angulo, a matchup of power punchers. One seems to be more of a boxer, another one seems to be a brawler. Let's start with James Kirkland, the American. 29-1, 26 KOs, his background. Convicted of armed robbery, jailed for 2 years in 2003. In 2009, put away again, found carrying a loaded gun. When he came back, he did not come back with his longtime trainer, Ann Wolfe. Now that seemed to be a huge thing for him, because he got knocked out by a guy who simply could not punch in Nobuhiro Ishida on HBO. It seemed to be surprising to everybody. Wolf and Kirkland reunite. He knocks out two no-names. One of them was even 9 years older than him, 8 years older than him, and he looks pretty stellar. What would you say, Robert, is the one flaw of James Kirkland?
Well, I mean, the one flaw is that he gets hit. I mean, he doesn't have a great defense. Aside from his troubles outside the ring, which I would consider a flaw, he does get hit. But he has the gift of power, which is incalculable. I mean, it's something that, you know, few people are gifted with, and he happens to be one of them. So that's what he brings to the ring Saturday night.
You know, it seems like he has this one gear, and that is go forward. Stalk, 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 throw, throw, throw. But as you said, he does get hit. Would you say that his chin is a huge liability in this fight with Angulo?
I would say that he is vulnerable. Angulo is one hell of a fighter. He is not really a one-punch knockout artist the way Kirkland is, but he wears his fighter. He wears his opponents down. So Kirkland is vulnerable. This fight is not going to the scorecards.
Well, you know what? I was just going to ask you what round you think it'll go, the over-under, all of that. We'll get to that in a minute. Let's talk about Alfredo Angulo for a minute. He's with Nacho Beristain. Nacho, of course, trained Oscar De La Hoya, a Hall of Fame trainer. Meanwhile, Alfredo has had some problems away from the ring as well. It seems that he was kicked out of the United States for having a bad visa. He switched promoters. I mean, could there be more distractions for each opponent going into this fight?
I think distractions go with the territory. It's not easy being a boxer. It's not easy being a celebrity. And each of these guys is a celebrity in the worlds in which they travel. I think once they're in the ring, I mean, there's only going to be one thing on each of their mind, and it is searching for and destroying the man in front of him. So whatever distractions have led up to this point will disappear once the opening bell sounds.
So you said that going to the scorecards is not going to happen. The longest that James Kirkland has gone is 8 rounds. The longest Alfredo Angulo has gone is 11 rounds. Would you say that conditioning is totally thrown out the window in this fight?
I think so, because styles make fights, and both of these guys have got a killer instinct. I mean, they really sort of come to, you know, it's kill or be killed. And each of them are going to approach this fight that way. So I can't imagine that it goes beyond 4 or 5 rounds. Something tells me that one of them is going to go down. Kirkland is in tough. He's in with somebody who's a real pro. But again, Kirkland has got the great equalizer, you know, the Susie Q. I mean, if he lands it, something could happen.
Do you think that he'll land it?
I don't. I actually think that he's not the superior fighter in this particular match, but I think he's going to really give it his all. This is the kind of fight where you invite friends over to watch a fight. The people who don't like boxing, you say, you've got to come over, you've got to check out this fight, because that's the kind of fight it's going to be.
Well, would you say that James Kirkland is more of the brawler per se, and Alfredo Angulo is more of the boxer per se, who likes to throw punches and wear down his opponent?
I think that's a fair analysis. I think that Kirkland is rawer. He has you know, maybe more violent in his heart than Angulo. And he's a rawer fighter. He doesn't really quite have the skills. And he trains in such an unconventional way with Ann Wolf. Whereas Burstein is really, he's a classical trainer. He's, as you say, a Hall of Fame trainer. So he's going to add something to the mix.
So it seems like the two fighters could not be more different, it seems like. So in the end, I assume you have Alfredo Angulo winning this by way of knockout?
I do.
And what round would you say that'll occur in?
I would say the fourth or fifth round.
Really? So you think that it'll end somewhat early?
I do think it'll end early. Because again, I mean, as you know, both of them are going to be coming, you know, really right at each other. So I do think it's going to end early.
Well, I'm one of those suckers who is forgiving of James Kirkland. Not that he did anything to me, but I'm rooting for him in this fight. I think it is an incredibly tough fight for him to take. Alfredo Angulo, although when you look at the two, he may look somewhat smaller than James Kirkland, but he has that power, and he is a much better boxer than James Kirkland. So I guess we will wait and see Saturday night. Robert Exel, the editor-in-chief of Boxing.com, thank you very much for the time, as always.
My pleasure. Talk to you soon.
Hi, this is Ben Mankiewicz along with Rookie Mankiewicz, and Rookie has an important message for you.
Subscribe to TYT Sports!